Welcome to our Proactive Studios. I'm Natalie Stoberman, joined by the CEO of Phunware, Randall Crowder. So great to have you on, Randall.
Thanks, Natalie. It's great to be here.
Well, there's some big news coming out from the third quarter results. Tell me all about it.
Yeah, you know, so, I mean, it's really a continuation of this year. I think if you look back over the last 12 months, it's kind of been an inflection point for us. So, you know, we did over 300% year-over-year growth in Q1. We did over 280% year-over-year growth in Q2, and then over 100% year-over-year growth in Q3. And so really what it is about giving people mobile strategies. And so, you know, half of our revenue is kind of, you know, platform revenue. Half is hardware revenue. But what we're really trying to endeavor to do is drive, you know, mobile strategies for folks. And we've really had some really indicative wins this year. And so, you know, from deploying it at Atlantis in the Bahamas to deploying it at Norfolk Southern, a smart workplace solution, even in the midst of the pandemic, it's really indicative of where we're trying to think about 2023, pardon. And so healthcare and hospitality are going to kind of probably reign supreme for us. We saw that even in Q3, about half of our pipeline is healthcare, about a quarter of it is hospitality. And we're really trying to kind of capitalize on about a $50 million pipeline going into the next year. A lot of that going to be an indirect channel strategy. And so really excited about kind of the progress we made this year to set us up more for the progress we're going to make next year.
Well, tell me all about the progress that we can expect for next year.
Yeah, so we did just announce a new CEO in place. And so really excited to, you know, welcome Russ Bice. He'll be joining us on kind of the very end of December and then kind of really full time, you know, starting next year. Great product and engineering background. And so I think that's always been kind of the challenge for us as a company. We've not always been great about allocating resources. You know, I think we always got to be transparent and honest with our shareholders. And so really going into 2024, it's going to be, you know, I keep saying 2023, it's going to be all about discipline. You know, it's all about, you know, how do we minimize dilution? You know, how do we get really disciplined around the cash that we have? But we're going to be focusing on commercializing our internal tools so that we can sell them in more of a SaaS format. And so first, we're going to start with healthcare and hospitality doing that. Russ comes to us with a great background in product engineering. You know, how do you build and scale SaaS solutions? That's exactly what we need. We are very good at delivering solutions. We need to productize those better, and we'll be able to see, you know, increased margins. And so the goal next year will be able to shift kind of our revenue composition, not so heavy in hardware, more in software. And I think he'll be, you know, really helpful in doing that. But along the way, we want to minimize dilution so we can maximize shareholder value.
Well, that all sounds great. But for some investors who may not be fully familiar with Phunware, can you at least dive in a little more into the bread and butter behind the company?
Yeah, no, I'm glad you asked that. You know, so, you know, we got our start building mobile applications. So back in 2009, less than 3% of internet content was consumed on mobile. Fast forward to today, that's, you know, well over 60%. And the majority of that is native mobile applications. So if you think about the, you know, the role mobile plays in our lives today, you know, about 90% of the global internet population goes online via a mobile device. You know, we spend about a third of our waking hours on our phones. It's like 5 hours per day. And so if you don't have a mobile strategy, you're really going to get left behind. And so Phunware is really endeavoring to tech enable contextual engagement through a mobile device. And so, you know, all about getting the right content to the right consumer at the right time in the right place, ultimately to help our customers make money, save money, or get more out of their money. And so when you think about like an Atlantis and the Bahamas, you know, it's an island in and of itself. And so that entire island is managed now by our software solution for hospitality. They made over $50,000 through our app the first couple of days they were live. They made over $500,000 in the first few months. And so that kind of incremental revenue and that desire to really give an incredible enhanced guest experience is going to be table stakes, especially in the hospitality industry. But healthcare remains, you know, one of our biggest customers and one of our biggest focus. And so how do you tech enable the continuum of care? We live in a mobile first world, so you've got to do that through a mobile application. That's what we're delivering to hospitals like Virginia Hospital Center, Greater Baltimore Medical Center. You know, those are some of our more recent deployments. And then we just announced in Q3 an expansion of Parkview Health, as well as a contract renewal. And so these hospitals are looking at demystifying the healthcare experience. And you have to have a mobile strategy to do that. And so I think there's a lot of really exciting opportunities to turn your mobile device into a mobile concierge, have it be less passive and just sitting in your pocket, and don't think about it as something you just binge watch Netflix on, but something that really enhances your real world experiences and allows you to get more out of those experiences by tech enabling them.
That sounds fantastic. It makes a huge difference when other industries are catching up with the premise of being in a mobile first world.
Absolutely. It's quickly feeling like it's mobile only. And so I think a lot of brands are waking up to that. And I think, we got slowed down because of the pandemic. That's when I kind of talk about being, more judicious with our resources. But we're seeing that thaw now. And so going into 2023, it's really going to be all about, how rapidly does the COVID-19 kind of freeze thaw? And then also what role crypto will play. We do have a lot of progress being made in what we're doing around crypto. But as you can see from the kind of macro trends, there's a lot of noise. It happens every time there's, disruption. I mean, you think about all the crazy dot-com ideas that were around in the 90s. The same thing's happening in crypto. It's good for us. We are one of the only public companies doing what we're doing. We were the first to go public with a digital asset. We're the first to launch a digital asset that has kind of appeared in a decentralized finance land. And so for us, it's all about how do we do it compliantly? How do we give blockchain, to enterprises in a safe, compliant manner that allows them to extend the features of our platform? And I think that's going to be the future of crypto. You can't have this unregulated, crazy nonsense where, kids are just, pretending to be entrepreneurs and just burning through money. You need centralized organizations commercializing decentralized ecosystems so that you have accountability and a sense of urgency and a responsibility to deploy a healthy ecosystem that is not, rife with fraud and ego.
Randall, it sounds like we're going to have lots to talk about over the coming year. Thank you so much for the update, everyone. Again, the CEO of Phunware, Randall Crowder.
Appreciate you.